Shut up.
How'd it go?
Don't ask.
Still got my novel.
Sorry.
Buy me lunch?
Hell no. She ain't never gonna be allowed to eat at her fucking desk, man. This is bullshit.
60 cents. Yeah, what are you doing? Keep the change.
Oh, well, at least he's gonna pay.
It's the whole shakedown, actually. All you really need to know. They don't sell ideas or campaigns or jingles. They sell media.
Maybe he was just in a pilot, man. That would be disappointing.
Although, it's never advertising. Submitted for your approval.
Wait, that's the douchebag's name, isn't
it? One Peter Campbell. A man who recently discovered that the only place for
He's on his honeymoon. They said that. Gotcha.
Away from the elevator so we can't sneak out.
Well, now we only have 5 minutes left for lunch.
You know,
their time management when it comes to eating meals is really disturbing me.
Sterling Coop is positively Cro-Magnon. I have a friend, I'm not even going to say what agency, but all they do is smoke Mary Jane and play dogs. So honestly, I think they're the best store on the street.
Thanks for lunch. Sorry about your copy.
Thanks for reminding me.
Yeah, I had almost forgotten.
I can never get used to the fact that most of the time it looks like you're doing nothing.
It really does.
4:30, close enough.
And I ain't never worried about it. You know this.
It includes Pete Campbell.
Oh, shit.
I should go to Niagara Falls for 2 weeks. Does wonders for your career.
Niagara Falls. Boy, redefines lack of imagination.
I know, right? Like, that's just idiotic. Even back then, it was a fucking cliche.
Let me ask you something. What do women want?
It's a terrible movie. Quit bringing it up.
You mentioned the other night that your daughter had been to a psychiatrist.
I'm sure you must be mistaken about that.
Oh, shit.
I am very comfortable with my mind. Thoughts clean and unclean, loving and the opposite of that.
You can't even say it, so you're not very comfortable.
Who could not be happy with all of this?
You're not happy, motherfucker.
Jesus, you know what they want? Everything. Especially if the other girls have it. Trust me, psychiatry is...
That's it. That's the key to this fucking ad campaign. Make it seem like the other women already have the deodorant for their men.
Beauty and the Beast.
Hey, Daddy.
Hey there. Cold lamb sound good?
No, it sounds like shit.
Oh, my God.
White gold.
Well, this will make my hands even heavier. Tiny little faces that you have to be. I'll crash even better. Thank you so much.
The guy at the store set the time, but he was English, so it might be 6 hours off.
Damn.
Did you look at...
Casual racism.
I think she has a bruise.
I didn't see it.
On her cheekbone, under her eye.
Did he even look at the kids?
I thought that was
ketchup. I still don't believe he knows the kids' names. He called them Beauty and
the Beast. What if she had gotten a scar?
Nothing happened.
I keep thinking...
Dude, she ain't okay.
Not that I could have killed the kids, but... worse, it's...
Send them to hell? Like, what is worse than death?
And gone on living with this...
Jesus.
Horrible scar on her face and...
Hey, Don. Give her some fucking help.
Long...
Jesus Christ,
lonely.
Man. This is what we call a red flag. Like, Jesus, dude.
Do I need to see someone?
Yeah, maybe you need another watch.
I don't know.
Well, that's... He's shifted a little bit. Yeah. Thank fucking Christ.
11 a.m. Did you get fired?
Brought Betty into the city to see the doctor, but honestly...
So he goes to a side piece? Like, Jesus, man.
I'm serious, Don. Don't talk to me about her.
Yeah, Dick.
That makes me feel cruel.
Just let me use you, baby.
You're right. I can't decide if you have everything or nothing.
Well, she don't have a TV anymore because she's fucking crazy. Like I said, man. Yeah, well, as long as you're with her, treat her right. Like, it may sound like I'm talking both sides of my neck, but treat her right if you're with her. But you shouldn't be with her because she's fucking nuts.
Could you be a gentleman and break into the fire escape so I don't have to?
Oh, shit. That's right. This sounds dubious to sell, Beth. He's got to climb through broken fucking TV parts and shit.
Draper in yet?
He's not coming in today. He's not feeling well.
I'm leaving. Don't tell anyone I was here.
Nicely played, sir.
I don't think I can go out to lunch today. Mr. Draper's not coming in.
That means you can go out to lunch. Have you never worked in an office before?
Well, he could call. It's my second week. Another time? I did enjoy the tour the other day. It was eye-opening.
I didn't think your eyes could be any wider.
Damn, dude.
That's clever.
Really? I guess we know why you closed the door.
I think we've misunderstood each other.
Yeah, clearly.
There is someone else, right?
Yes.
I mean, that's the only way he's going to back off, so whatever. And I know, like, she fucked Peter, is it? Whatever his name is. So she's kind of telling the truth, but still, that's the only way to get him off your ass.
Hey, look at these letters you typed after lunch. Terre Haute, Indiana has two R's.
Oh, shit.
And an A. And
Jesus
an E at the end.
Christ.
I think either you missed home row by a hand or you were out drinking with the junior account boys again.
Wasn't drinking.
I don't like your tone.
Damn.
I'll redo these right away. Look at you, all in a snit.
Well, you said you don't like your tone, like a bitch.
Look, dear, I don't know you that well. But you're the new girl, and you're not much, so you might as well enjoy
Jesus
it while
Jesus Christ, what a cunt. So we have a miserable cunt for this show.
Don't be that way. I'm just offering some perspective, that's all.
You're going to let me type these letters or not? I'm trying to get the fuck out of here.
Thank you, Joan. I'll save my thank yous till you correct that correspondence.
Talk about, I don't like your tone, and then say, why are you in a snit, boy? Unbelievable.
I can see no matter how.
I mean, she basically feels like a fucking medium rare steak, I'm sure. I get what they're doing here. For the love of God, please don't be pregnant.
When you have a problem with your car and you go to the mechanic and it's not doing it anymore. Not that you are a mechanic.
Mechanic for the brain is close enough. I think the only thing worse than the state of medicine back then was the state of psychiatry.
A lot of people must come here worried about the bomb. Is that true?
He's falling asleep. Plus, he can't talk because they would have to pay him more. So.
Oh. Lock the door when you leave.
Did he say that he took his wife to the doctor? Like, was he supposed to take her home? Or, like, what the fuck? I'm having a few timeline questions here.
Take a shower. You stink.
God damn.
Because I'm the man. What do women want?
A man who doesn't stink.
Well, one of the things has to be not being asked something like that.
What do women want? You know better than to ask.
You could do something with that. I think you're close.
What do women want? Any excuse to get closer.
I don't know. I like the you know better than to ask better.
Excellent. Cream spinach or cream corn?
Man, this both sound horrible.
Fried potatoes or old-fashioned?
Old-fashioned. That's right. Put that fruit straight in there, motherfucker. Drink it like a civilized person.
Apparently, the phone company wants to start charging people for unlisted numbers.
That doesn't seem fair.
Some people agree with you, and they're giving aliases to Ma Bell. They call it the nom de phone.
Shut up.
I'll be right up.
I assume there's a babysitter somewhere in the house. Look, man, I got questions.
Very interesting hour with your wife.
Oh, so he does get to talk.
She's a very anxious young woman.
Well, that met my expectations. It's very good. This is going to be a show that, you know, another deep character study, which I like. I've got the weirdest issue. It's not an issue. It's a question. It's like the logistics situation. As a writer, these are the things you obsess over. Okay, so he takes his wife in the city to see a doctor, right? Therapist appointment's an hour. He goes over, fucks his side piece, falls asleep, and she's talking about, you know, she has to go somewhere and shit. And then, while they're still in the city, he takes his wife to dinner and shit before they go back home. I don't know how all that works. Like, you know, how do you get all that done? In the 1 hour, did she? What I would do is as a writer, I would talk about, well, there's, you know, she went shopping around the corner or something, you know, like, you know, he has some shit to do in the city, he tells her. So once she's shopping, maybe she gets a little snack or somewhere, like, I can see that, right? But, like, as a writer, these are the details you obsess over. And as an editor, those are the details, and a director, those are the details you cut out of scripts because it don't fucking matter. It literally doesn't matter. Who gives a shit, right? So my writing brain is at war with my directing brain and my editing brain. You know, these are the problems filmmakers have, you know. Especially when you do all of them. If you just have one job, you can just be focused on that. And you put this shit in the script. And it's like, well, we don't need to know these details. Who cares? It doesn't matter that he apparently spent 4 leisurely hours at this apartment with this chick. And meanwhile, their appointment is clearly only 1 hour. That doesn't matter. As a writer, you put those details in there. And then the editors be like, yeah, we ain't got time for this shit. And they cut it out. So when you only have one job, you just do your job. You put the details in there as a writer. Or as an editor, you take the details out because you don't give a shit. And the editor don't give a shit if the writer looks like an idiot. I swear to God, this is why like so many writers look like idiots. The editor don't give a fuck. He cares about the pacing of the story. That's all he cares about. He don't care if it makes sense, if it's logical, nothing. How is it paced? We don't want motherfuckers falling asleep in the third act. So, you know, and then the director, of course, he has a lot of things he cares about. But his primary concern is not plot holes. I don't care what YouTube essayist wants you to believe. The director's primary concern is not plot holes. He don't give a shit. All right. Well, we're going to get another episode. So let's go ahead and let me stop talking so we can get to that.
I think I'm not feeling so great. I called in sick.